everybody, welcome to today's video. If you did not know, this month is dedicated to reviews on my channel. I've been posting a lot of reviews, but today I thought let me give a break to that and do my favorite lip products, which is kind of a review, to be honest, of all the lip products that I like. But you all have been showing interest in me doing a lip product kind of video, so I thought let me give what you want. So I've got about 1, 2, 3, 4 I've got about 5-6 products over here that I just want to talk about quickly, so let me get right into it. Let me start with the lip therapy. Let me start with the first step, which is moisturizing your lips. And for that, this is actually a cosmetic and a moisturization thing. This is the Clarins Lip Oil. It is an instant light lip comfort oil which enhances and nourishes. This is what it looks like. This retails for 1900 rupees, which is quite expensive. Let me open it first of all. The color, by the way, is 03 Red Berry. You open it like that. This is the actual product. It looks super fancy. Do you see how much I've used already of this? Yeah. So this is the product that you're getting in this for 1900 rupees. I've had this for a long time, like for a few months, and I have used this kind of on the daily. I've really been off liquid lipstick. Like this kind of lipstick I've not been wearing lately. I just wear this lip oil. Now this is, you might be seeing over there and you're like, ooh, that's pigmented, but it does not come out like that. It comes out transparent with a little bit of red tint to it, and that is just what I like, guys. It's a lip oil, but it's sticky, so it's kind of like a lip gloss if it was nourishing, and it's more thick, and it just feels so nice on the lips, guys, especially being a cabin crew. I wear makeup every single day, so on my off days I want like a break, but if I'm going out I want something on my lips. I would go heavy on the eyes maybe and then just put this on. It's perfect. Gives a really high shine glossy look without the color. So in the summers, if you're applying a lot of gloss, you don't want a color also. It just looks very too much because you're already sweating and everything. If you're gonna buy an expensive lip product, this should definitely be on the list. I actually bought it because Zoella raves about it all the time. I was like, okay, fine, let me go and try it out. And I loved it with all my heart. One thing that I really admire about it is the applicator of it. So as can you see, I'm not able to take it out very easily. It's nice, seal and tight. Can you see how thick and see that shape? It's very thick and it's spongy and it's just perfect. It applies the product so well, and you can't just, it's not easy access. However, if you keep it out in heat, it does leak out from here. So be careful about that, especially if you have white furniture like me. That's gonna be an issue. Now next is another lip prep product. This is the Kiko Milano Invisible Lip Liner. I know, what is that all about? So this is what it looks like. This retails for $8.90 or $9.90, I'm not sure. I think it's $8.90. I'm not sure. That is how much it is. Again, a bit on the pricier side for what? A lip liner? That too invisible? Huh? But hear me out. So first off, look at the packaging. How fancy does that look? It's just basic with a little rose gold line over here. Looks very minimal and classy. Now, as I said, it is transparent. What this is for? Maybelline Lip Gradation Lipstick, we have to use it at work, and that just makes my lips so dry, and at the end of the day my lips just become chapped and they're just so bad and peeling in the inside especially. So I wanted something like a barrier between the lip product and my lips. But of course, if I would apply a colored pencil or a nude pencil, even the color of the lip product would change, and I did not want that. I already have pigmented lips, so they do the color changing effect in itself. And even a nude lip liner did not work because that made the color look a bit muted. So this is perfect as a barrier. Even under your liquid lipsticks, you could apply it and that would be a nice barrier. Or if you want to make your product stay, guys, that lip gradation lipstick does not stay much, okay? It bleeds out of your lips because it's meant for lip gradation basically. But this makes it stay, guys, it really does. And once you apply it, your lips will look a bit grayish. So this does leave a little bit of like a whitish tint to it. And then when you apply your lipstick, you will feel at that very second that your lipstick is just more closer to your lip skin, if that's possible, I don't know. And it just, you will feel like the lipstick is more secure and it's just, it sticks better, okay? And it does make the lipstick stay on for so long, guys. Even if I'm doing like four sectors, I would have to replenish my lipstick twice in every sector. But with this, I apply it once in two sectors after eating, which is like, wow, amazing. This is an amazing product. The only downside is that you do have to sharpen it. So in that way, a lot of the product is lost even, but hey, it's okay. I've not heard of an invisible lip liner or anything with this kind of an idea in any other brand. If you have, please make sure to put that in the comments below, a product that's available in India easily. Next, let's check out two lipstick. First one is from the Lakme 9-to-5 creaseless range. Actually, Apurva Beautyol 0710 or Bae gifted this to me. The color is Apricot Ace, which is actually a really nice shiny dirty pink color. It's a really nice color, guys. First of all, the bottle, just the packaging looks so classy, it's rose gold, like why not? And it smells divine. It smells like vanilla cake or something, so nice. And the bullet is just perfect to keep in your purse. It's not gonna take a lot of space in it and looks stylish also when you apply it. It's definitely crease less and I love the product. Now since I have pigmented lips, the color does show up a bit nude on my lips, but if it was a different color, I would love it. I love this lipstick line, and it just, when you apply, does not feel like you're applying a lipstick in particular. It feels very hydrating. It feels a bit, not oily I would say, but moisturizing in that sense. Next lipstick is my favorite lipstick ever when it comes to a brown lipstick. This is by Chambord. The color is 174 Melon Sorbet. I use this in almost every single video last autumn, and all of you used to ask me every time. Even now when I wear this lipstick, you guys ask me every time, like, which lipstick are you wearing? We need to know. This is the one. This is what it looks like. This was actually my mom's, but she never ended up using it, so I was like, huh, let me try it. And it's just the perfect color. I've always wanted to find a color that I can wear without putting makeup on my face. And this color looks so beautiful, even if I don't have any makeup at all on my face. It's hydrating and it's just, it's a lovely product, guys. Smells like lipstick, but it's a lovely color. I would definitely recommend the color. Not next up, I've got two liquid lipsticks. The first one is the In Color Matte Me Lipstick. Now, guys, I'm like, okay, look, now I won't say, like, these liquid lipsticks are not good quality. They're not gonna stay for, like, you know, whatever, when people are reviewing liquid lipsticks, they say, oh, this flakes, this does that. These lipsticks, they do everything that they say that a liquid lipstick is not supposed to do. But I still love it because it's cheap and it is easy to remove and it is just, it's cool. I mean, I wear lipstick every single day. So on my offs, I don't want a lipstick that stays on from like life to death. I just want a normal lipstick. I like to take my lipstick off while I'm eating food or something. Otherwise, it's just very gross for me. I would say it's okay. Again, with this lipstick, I'm recommending the color to you. So if you want a pinky nude, this color from the Matte Me range called 415 is perfect. Again, a lot of you have asked me so many times, which lipstick are you wearing? It's this one. So I'm recommending the color here, not the product, because the product is not good. It's gonna flake off, it's gonna come off. If you just eat a little bite of anything, if you drink something, it's gonna come off and it flakes. You cannot apply more layers of it. So yeah. Not a good product per se, but the color is nice. So if you're just looking for a nice everyday lipstick that you don't care really about, that, ooh, it should stay on forever, like, you know, an everyday color that's like not even too expensive and you want to try a liquid lipstick, maybe this is great. It can retail anywhere from 150 to 250, so good range of colors, and I like it a lot. So this 415 color is my fave. Last but not the least is like the most expensive thing, and that is the Kylie Lip Kit. I personally love the Kylie Lip Kit. People have different opinions on it. I've actually reviewed this, which I will link over here in the bottom bar below. So I got the True Brown K Lip Liner and the Dolce K Liquid Lipstick. I got this from KylieCosmetics.com, which is the official website, which is from where you should buy it too, if you want a legit actual product. I love the combination of it. This does not come together. This is a darker brown, as you can see, and this is a lighter color. If I use this on its own, it just washes me out because this is like the perfect nude for me. But this just erases my lips for me on my skin and I don't really want that. So I use a darker lip liner with the lighter lipstick. It works perfectly. I apply this, like focus it on the middle of my lips, and a little goes a long way in there. I think this will last me for a lifetime because you have to use so little of it. This, however, I think I will be running out quite soon because you do have to sharpen it. So again, product gets lost and you do end up using a lot of the product. And this is pretty tiny. shiny as compared to what it came. So I've used a lot of this. I love the lip liner on its own. So if you don't want to spend a lot of money buying the actual kit or anything, you could totally just buy the lip liner and be done with it. The lip liners are not too drying, but they do stay on very nicely. The liquid lipstick can be a bit drying if you use it for a really long period or again and again, but then you can scrub your lips and just moisturize them and be done with it. I love the actual combo of it. These colors especially work perfectly. Again, I can wear this lip combo without putting anything else on my face, maybe a mascara, and then I'm done with the day. So I love this product because I really like lipsticks that look good on you even if you don't have any makeup on. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below which is your favorite lipstick ever, because I would love to try it. Make sure to like this video up. I've made other review videos throughout the month which would already have appeared over here on the screen. Make sure to click on them after watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye bye till then.